Messick's, a helping hand with your land.
Hi, Tom with Messick Farm Equipment. Today we have a T7-315. We're going to go over some of the basic operation, getting it started, moving it forward and reverse. This is a CVT transmission, so it's got some nice features for speed ranges, and we'll cover those things. So let's go up in the cab and take a look at what we got. All right, so now we're up in the cab. First things first, we're going to go over starting the tractor. Key switch here on the right side underneath your windshield wiper stick. So to start the tractor, we want to step on the clutch, make sure it's in park. 9 times out of 10 it will be if it was shut off properly. So you make sure that the forward reverse lever is in the park position. You can see that by the indication here underneath the steering wheel. There's a P, you push down and go over. So we've got it in park. Cycle the key, accessories come on, you have your dash light cycle, and you just continue into the start position. Underneath the dash, underneath the steering wheel, we have a lever. This lever gets pushed down and you can tilt the steering wheel towards you. You also can telescope the steering wheel by adjusting it with the center tightening knob. Turn signals, like I said, windshield wipers are here, four-way flashers are all here on the dashboard. More importantly, again, the forward and reverse lever is here. It's currently in park. When you're ready to go into forward and reverse, you take it out of park, select either forward or reverse, and you can move in that direction with your CVT lever once you do that. Other controls, you have your this particular tractor has 4 electronic hydraulic remotes. There's also a set of remotes on the front of this tractor that correspond with one of these. It's got a separate loader valve, PTO switches, hand throttle, as well as a foot throttle on the floor. And your standard left and right brake are there on the floor as well. The basics of getting this unit to go forward and backwards consists pretty basically of stepping on the clutch again, stepping on the brake, and you take that forward and reverse lever, pull it over, up, and we're going to go in reverse, so I'm going to pull it back towards me. And you see on the dash, it gives you an indication that you're going in reverse, and you also see on your IntelliView, it's telling you you're in reverse. We're currently in range 3. Of the 3 ranges, you can cycle down with your joystick here, plus and minus buttons. So we're in range 3. If I hit minus, I'm in range 2. That's currently set to 5 miles per hour. Range 1 is set at 3 miles per hour. I'm going to leave it in range 1, and we'll take our foot off the brake, take our foot off the clutch. We aren't going anywhere because we have a CVT, and we either need to step on the foot pedal or use the joystick to move in that direction. So we're set reverse. I'm going to go backwards by pulling backwards on this lever. There we start to move. And it tells me I'm doing 0.6. I've only started into part of the stroke of the CVT transmission. It's 0.6 miles per hour. I'm going to push forward again and stop. And there we're at 0. Now if I want to go forward again, I can either move my joystick over here and go forward. And there we're forward. We're going forward again. I'm going to shuttle back to reverse here with the lever. No need to step on the clutch. I just brought it back towards me. That takes us right back to where we left the stick. We can come back a little bit further. So we shuttled with the stick over here, forward and reverse. On the joystick, there's also a forward and reverse button. Now I want to go forward. I'm going to push that. And you see it's changing directions. We go forward, and then I want to go reverse. I hit reverse. There's a little C down here. C is cruise. If I want to go 3 miles an hour and get there without having to hold the lever, I hit C, and it takes that guy to 3 miles per hour without having to take the lever there. I'll go back forward again, and we're back full throttle on the CVT transmission. Okay, so that was the first range. Say you're doing a slow type operation. Let me get back and forward here. This forward speed is 8 miles an hour. If I want to do something a little slower, I have the option to really dial that down with this side knob right here. I'm bringing it down 7 miles per hour, six. Say you want to creep along at 2.5 miles per hour. There I have it set at 2.5 miles per hour. I'll put it in reverse, back up a little bit because I don't have room. And now when we go forward again, I can hit that cruise button. So I'm going to go forward, and I'm going to hit cruise, and it's going to take us to 2.5 miles per hour, and I don't have to push the lever, and I know that's where I'll be maxed out at in that range. So that was range one. You can again cycle up to range two and have an infinite amount of speed ranges there. If I were to come down below 2 miles per hour in range two, it's going to knock range one down as well. It will always bring the next side down range to match. You can't go into range one and have it be a higher speed than range two. Three is set at 26. This tractor has a max speed of 26 miles per hour. So I'm going to go out here on the road or in this open space. I'll back up a little bit. And we're going to go forward and get it going right up to cruise. So we'll go forward. We're in the forward spot. We hit the cruise button and off we go. I didn't mention on this joystick, there's a big end with a lever pushing in. If for some reason you had to stop and you just wanted to sit in neutral but not necessarily have it on park, you can hit that button and you see it takes it into neutral, both on your screen and on your dashboard. We're sitting in neutral. And then to go forward again, hit the forward button. I did have to hit the forward lever there, I apologize, not the forward button. You do have to acknowledge with the lever. So that gets you going again. Other buttons on the joystick here, you have three-point arm up and down, headland turn sequence where you can program hydraulic functions to go up and down, and then you have the options to put remote functions on this pad over here for hydraulic remotes to stroke those while you're holding those instead of having to come down here onto your levers. So that is some of the basics in the cab here. We're going to come to a stop. It'll say zero. We've got a lever pulled all the way back. Step on the clutch, push down and over to get it in park. And you have a P over here on your screen. It tells you you're in park. And then you can simply just turn the key off. Put the steering wheel back in place. And you're ready to move on to your next operation. So that's how you operate a T7-315. If you have any questions, be sure to call 1-800-222-3373. And ask for the sales department.